is only my second. The first one was when Dad and I got married. God called me up and asked me to do a toast, and I didn't know what to do, so I wrote a little poem. And didn't know till the other day how much that poem meant to my dad. Because he carried that with him, he liked to show people. So I've written another poem, and I think my kids are taking bets on how long I can get into this. So, but I do have a backup here in case I falter. So this poem's called "I Hope My Father Knows." I hope my father knows how much I really love him. What a blessing he has been to us throughout the years. I hope my father knows how much I learned from him. His wit, wisdom, and caring heart he modeled well for me. I hope my father knows the impact of his love. He touched our lives in many ways. For that I'm truly grateful. I know I should have told him that the time was never right. He wasn't one to speak these things. He kept things to himself. So as his son, I too kept mum, where feelings were expressed. I know my father knows Jesus is his Savior. I know that he has gone to be in heaven eternally. I know that he is resting there in Jesus' loving arms and basking in the glory in the presence of our King. I know that someday soon, in those mansions filled with glory, I'll see my dad and get to say things I hope my father knows.
So out on the memory table, later after our service, the original poem that Alan spoke of that he wrote for Mom and Jim's wedding is on that table up there if you'd like to read it. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Janet Green. I'm Donnie's oldest daughter. I have known Jim for a little over 20 years, and I would describe him as the most complexly simple man that I have ever met. So many things were important to him, and he gave his all to each one. God, church, government, family, local community, people, library, friends, Habitat for Humanity, family, Angel Food Ministries, family, and the list goes on. The Constitution and helping the younger generation understand the importance of it was his passion. He loved the kids. He loved working with the kids at Sunday school and VBS as much as with all his grand and great-grandkids. He had researched online and found a recipe for Big Bubbles. We all wondered what Big Bubbles were. But he ordered all the stuff and he put it all together and it took big sticks and a lot of string, but we made Big Bubbles, and they were awesome. The kids loved them. This earned him the affectionate name of Mr. Bubbles among the kids in PBS and Sunday school. This was cool for Mom and Jim, as Mom always played the piano for the kids over the years, and she has been referred to as Mrs. Bubbles because of a song that they loved from years ago. So each of them, for their own reasons, became Mr. and Mrs. Bubbles. One of his recent stays in the hospital, the kids sent him cards that they had made, and most of them had drawn bubbles on them and referred to bubbles. Reading each one carefully, the bubble references brought tears to his eyes, and they were happy ones. I remember him saying, "Every experience is a learning opportunity." I remember years ago, he fell on his way to work in the parking lot at Pure Carbon. He broke both elbows. uncomfortable, but I said that I was sorry and asked him what I could do to help. His reply was, there really isn't anything that we can do but wait for it to heal and most likely watch a lot of TV. I said later as I was leaving, I was sorry that it had been such a crappy day. He smiled and he said, well, it's not so bad. Today I learned not to cut across the ice in the parking lot, no matter how much of a hurry I'm in. His pride was in his family. He loved each of us and was so proud of all our accomplishments, big or small, and just simply who we are. Last Friday, after a meeting with his doctors, he proudly pointed out each one of those of us who were able to be there. Going from one to the next, introducing us, his family. We were all the same. We were all important. He introduced his kids by name. The doctors met each one of us by name. Didn't matter if we were his child, his stepchild, his daughter, his son-in-law, his daughter-in-law. We were introduced as the kids, the family. Recently, I had attended the Gaines Township meetings, and I would sit next to him. A couple months ago, I was hired as the township secretary. My first meeting to sit up at the head table, I was getting my things all together, and I saw him come in. Took his place in the back where he normally sat, got his papers out, his pen ready, and talked to the people that were sitting next to him. When the meeting started, I looked up, smiled, and waited for it to begin. And the first thing I saw was at the center of the third table back, Jim. Ear-to-ear smile, the big, happy smile that we all know. And he had his hands right beside his face, and he was going, so I waved back at him. I didn't care who saw me. I waved back at him because I was proud that he was obviously proud. Technology, we all know, he loved his gadgets. He was eager and not afraid of that next upgrade that was always right around the corner. Always trying the latest thing offered. From complex to simple, he loved things technology could do. One day last week, while three of us were on our way to Geisinger, we made a lot of trips to Geisinger the last few days. Chris, his son, sent out a message saying, just so you know, Janet, Amy, and Nell are on their way. Dad's tracking them. He was a witness and a leader, simply doing both by example and making an impact on people that he had no idea he was making. He's a leader here in our church family, a love and strength that will be missed by each one of us. From those who have been here and known him for years to those who are just joining us, he's a pillar in our church congregation, though he wouldn't describe himself as such. Again, simple and subtle way of leading by example. Jim was a witness for God in all that he did. Even in his last days, he greeted everyone. His greeting to everyone was with a calm smile, saying all was okay. He is at peace with what was happening, and he trusted God to take him home when it was time, that he was ready, had lived a good life of many years, and was ready for the next step. Though he will miss us all, he will see us all again one day, and his focus was on God and what was in store for him next. He was obviously not afraid, again, not realizing, but leading by example. On Sunday, our family was there, my girls, my grandkids, and Dave and I, and he looked up at the girls and he said, it's okay. He said, I got the easy part. And we smiled and he said, I've been where you are. He said, I know what you're going through. He said, I've been there and it's not easy, but just remember to be there for each other because I've got the easy part. I'm going home. He said, and I'll see you again. That's a sort of testimony that makes me very proud. I've learned a lot from Jim, mostly just in everyday life. He is proud of each of us and will continue to be our strength as we go through life using the tools that he taught us. Treat every experience, good or bad, as a positive and positive learning opportunity. Life is short. Do what makes you happy. Love God. Prayer is important. Have respect for your country. Do what you can. where you are to make a difference. Cherish your family. Thank you, Jen, for being a part of our family, for treating Mom so well, for giving her so many fun experiences and memories. I'm proud to be your stepdaughter, and please know that we will all miss you so very much.
I'm Jim Jones' son, Chris, just to say a few words. How deep the Father's love for us by Stuart Townsend is the song I chose as a soundtrack for the slideshow of Dad's Life that's out from the dust wheel there. And while the song itself is not talking merely of our human Father's love, but God the Father and God the Son, and their relationship and their love for us as humankind, this mysterious, unfathomable, infinite God speaks to us in comparisons that we can understand. Using loving relationships that we can understand. More on that in a second, but I'd just like to read the first verse of that song. How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. One of my earliest, fondest memories of Dad is him reading